Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to our channel, and thanks for logging on. If you enjoy these videos, do me a favor and subscribe to our YouTube channel right here at Watchbox Reviews. I'd really appreciate it, and I promise to update daily. If you like this watch, you can purchase it on our website, thewatchbox.com. Buy, trade, and sell luxury watches on thewatchbox.com. Today, I am privileged to introduce a watch that's actually a variant of one I own. I own the Platinum Jaeger-LeCoultre Master Grande Memovox, and this is the rose gold version. From 2001 to 2004, this was a low-volume flagship of the celebrated Memovox alarm watch line at Jaeger-LeCoultre, a brand known for its alarm watches. Featuring caliber 919, it is a moon phase coordinated perpetual calendar and an automatic winding system coupled to an alarm. And significantly, the alarm is hanging separate and free from the case, so it has a wonderful sonorous resonance to it that we will hear. It's also a stanced modern watch that's not oversized. 41.3 millimeters is the size from 9 to 3. Now, that's not including the crowns. It's not excessively thick, though it has a squat profile. It's only 15 millimeters thick, and you will find it slides easily under a cuff. Lug to lug, it's a nice constrained 49.6 millimeters, which I always say is a good measurement. Fewer than 50 millimeters is excellent for a smaller male wrist, which I define as about 16.5 centimeters to 14. My wrist is 16. The timepiece has a broad spacing about its lugs. For a timepiece made at the turn of the century, 21 millimeters is actually fairly progressive, and I find that it keeps the watch nicely planted on the wrist. It's a handsome piece and very substantial for two reasons. First, the deep case is coupled in tandem with a full solid gold case back, and second, you have a full folding clasp attached to this watch. Not a pin buckle, JLC spared no expense to fully appoint the flagship. Mine, in platinum, has a full platinum clasp, so all of these were well-appointed watches. And it is a rose, even red gold alloy, as you can see, nicely contrasting with the black of the strap. The strap is a medium rectangular scale semi-gloss with dramatic bolstering down its center to give it body and volume. A monotone stitch, you can see that it features folded edges, calfskin on the underside, and that clasp really is grand, as you can see. The Grande Memovox with a Grande clasp, nicely blasted and branded inside with a contrasting polish, no detail too small. And really, that continues about the watch, starting with the flanks of the lugs. As you'll note, there is a handsome but very subtle transitional bevel between the hoods of the lugs and the flanks of the case. You can see that the horizontal lines have been nicely defined, principally by the junction of the bezel lip, which has a very small vertical polished aspect that defines the case band. Extraordinarily handsome, but also elegant. You can see the dial is silver and beautifully balanced, as there is a cruciform symmetry to this watch that I find quite fetching. Everything is of the highest order, as you have real 18 karat rose gold diamond polished dart style indices hand applied. You have faceted and loomed alpha style hands rather than the heavier and somewhat awkward dauphines often used on dress watches. You have a number of registers, some of which pull double duty, such as the month featuring the year and the decade, and the crescent style moon phase, which also features a 24 hour or danger zone indicator, so you know, for example, whether you're looking at approximately 10:13 at night or 10:13 in the morning. You can see that the indicator is approaching 2:2 or just past 2:2, so you're actually looking at the danger zone. That's when you don't want to use the case side pusher to advance the mechanically programmed calendar. And indeed, you can't accidentally create a fictional combination of date, month, year, decade, day, and moon phase. All you do is advance the correct day for the month in which you are currently situated, and assuming the year is set correctly, and by the way, that is sequential as well, you will simply advance the date, advance the day, advance the month, and everything else moves in sync. No need to look up each of these individually. I know how the moon phase can be a pain for those of you who have simple calendar watches. Otherwise, it's perpetual. You never need to adjust it. Sure, there's a reckoning to be had in the year 2100, but that's not going to be a problem for most. You'll also note that there is a separate indicator on the dial for the alarm, and the alarm is set in roughly 5-minute increments. JLC has been kind enough to give you these small increments in blue printed outboard of the hours. I find that realistically, 5 minutes is about as precisely as you can set the watch. No matter how skilled you become, and I've experienced and owned my share of Memovox watches, 5 minutes seems to be about the best you'll achieve, and that's fine. I don't need to be reminded of something to the second. and it will go and go and go. At full wind, you'll get about 30 seconds of discharge out of the alarm. Especially when it's placed on a counter or a nightstand, it has a tendency to resonate immensely. So if this thing is on wood or glass, rest assured it will wake you up in the wee hours. And that's the acid test of any alarm watch. Can it serve as an alarm clock? Can it wake you up for a 3 a.m. red eye? And this one can. And that's because there's a wonderful bronze gong inside the case that hangs separate from the case. Previous generations of alarm watches simply struck the case or the case back. This one has a separate ringing resonance due to that bronze gong, and it's freestanding, I should say, and one of the reasons why there is a solid case back on the watch between the gong and the winding rotor. There's really not much to see. I'll take the solid gold case back, thanks. Now, the timepiece does have a 122-year programmed moon phase, two crowns with push-down action, and despite the fact that it is a dress complication, an impressive 50-meter water resistance. Now, you're not going to swim with this one, but it's nice to know you have a little bit in reserve next time you splash the watch or get caught out in the rain. Underneath the case back, 36 jewel caliber 919, adjusted in a chronometer-like six positions, 28,800 vibrations per hour, 45-hour power reserve. It does feature a stop seconds function, and you will note that you can actually stop the seconds hand completely, so you can measure intervals as large as 122 years with the precision of the moon phase, and as small as fractions of a second, thanks to the hacking seconds. There will be a loom shot at the end of this video, because this is a lightly loomed watch for maximum utility. The movement itself is a combination of the IWC Curt Claus Coordinated Perpetual Calendar Module and a Jaeger-LeCoultre 918 base movement, that is a 918 bidirectional winding automatic alarm. This is a watch that puts it all together with everyday usable hardware on the inside and finery on the outside, aesthetic balance and useful complication. The Grande Memovox is the total package. See it and make it yours on the watch box. And I'm back with the Jaeger-LeCoultre Master Grande Memovox. As you can see, a paucity of loom, but enough to discern the time. You can see it by day on the watch box.